Good morning. So we are continuing the lesson doping. We have discussed about the various substances used to enhance the performance. Means performance enhancing substances we have discussed. Now we are discussing today the topic is the physical method. Doping we have discussed, there are the methods of doping. First is the use of substances. The person use certain substances to enhance the performance in sports activity. Second is physical method of doping, in which the person use the physical methods to enhance the performance in sports. So there are two physical methods which are used by the sports person to enhance their performance. First is blood doping. Second is gene doping. Gene technologies are used, gene doping. The person use to change their genes. Genes are the genetic characters. These characters are in our gene, in DNA. These are known as the characters which always carried forward to the next generation. So the method by which the person is bringing change in his or her gene or DNA is known as gene doping. And blood doping, in which the person is infusing the blood, or the person is infusing the healthy blood of any person in his or her body in order to enhance his or her performance in sports. That is known as blood doping. We will discuss in detail about these physical methods. So first we are discussing the blood doping. According to WADA, the misuse of technique or substance to increase one's RBC count is known as blood doping. Means due to any technique or due to any use of any substance, if the RBC count are being increased, number of RBCs are increased in the body, that is also that is considered the blood doping. Athlete's blood is taken a few weeks prior to competition. This is the process I am telling you, how we come to know that the person has used the physical method of blood doping. As again I am reminding, in previous slide I have told you, in blood doping the person is taking the healthy blood of any person and infusing in his or her body. Means the person is infusing the blood of any healthy person in his or her body prior to the competition or in order to enhance performance in sports. So that is known as blood doping. When we are taking the healthy blood of any person in order to enhance the performance, that is blood doping. The processor of blood doping, how the blood doping is detected. Athlete blood is taken a few weeks prior to competition. One or two units of the blood is taken out from the athlete's body. And before the competition, and is separated, the plasma is separated from the blood and is frozen. It is preserved in the fridge until 1 or 2 days before the competition. And The blood cells, the plasma and blood cells are separated, and blood cells are kept in saline solution, and that is preserved in the freezer. And it is injected into the athlete's body just before the competition. Or while we are checking, we can inject these blood cells after preserving certain time duration. And during this period, the athlete is kept under the supervision and is given proper nutrition, nutritious diet, and he is kept under the supervision. And after that, these blood cells are again injected into the athlete's body. The procedure is known as autologous blood doping. This is known as autologous blood doping. If the person is using this process for in order to perform, in order to enhance the performance, or when the doping test is taken, that time these blood cells are injected into the body of the athlete, and it is checked that the naturally grown blood cells are similar to the cells or not. If they are not similar, so that is that means the athlete has taken the blood of someone else. If the blood cells are similar, it means that blood is of the athlete's body, that is, he has not taken, he or she has not taken any blood from outside. So this is the procedure of detecting the blood doping. We will discuss about the autologous blood doping. Autologous blood doping, what happens? The athletes used to take the blood of any healthy person before the competition, just before the competition, 1 or 2 days before the competition. And how they take, they also take in the same way. The blood, healthy blood, is taken by the athlete and it is preserved in the freezer. It is frozen and it is preserved. And after that preservation, before, just before few days of the competition, that blood is injected into the athlete's body. When the fresh blood of another person is taken and injected straight into the body of athlete, the procedure is known as homologous blood doping. Now, the autologous blood doping means that when the athlete is taking the blood and it is preserved, frozen, and then after that, before, just before the competition, that it is injected into the athlete's body, that is known as autologous blood doping. And when directly the athlete, the healthy person, is giving, donating blood and it is injected straight into the body of athlete, that is known as homologous blood doping. Means same time when the healthy person is donating blood and the athlete is injecting this blood in his or her body, that is homologous blood doping. When we inject blood, infuse the blood in our body after preserving it, that is known as autologous blood doping. This is about autologous and homologous blood doping. And then I have told you that what is the procedure of detecting it. Both type of homologous and autologous blood doping is detected by the procedure that I am repeating again. 1 or 2 units of the blood is taken out from the athlete's body. Plasma and blood cells are separated, and plasma converts into the liquid water quickly. But the RBCs are preserved, kept in saline solution, and it is preserved. And after 3-4 weeks, when after 3-4 weeks, these blood cells are again injected into the athlete's body. But during this period, for 3-4 weeks, the athlete is kept under the supervision and he or she is provided sufficient nutritious food and when we are injecting these preserved blood cells in the athlete's body, then again we check the blood of athlete to see the natural growth of RBCs and the injected RBCs are similar or not. The RBCs which are grown into the body of the athlete and the RBCs which are injected are similar or not. If there are similarities, so then we can say then athlete's blood doping is negative. If there is any difference in the RBCs, so we can say then athlete's blood doping is positive in both the cases, autologous blood doping and homologous blood doping detection. So this is about the blood doping and its type. Another process of the blood doping, another procedure of blood doping involves the injection of artificial oxygen carrier. Two type of blood doping we have discussed, autologous and homologous blood doping. This is used by the athlete. One more type of blood doping is seen, that is in which the athletes are injecting artificial oxygen carriers in their body. Now, what are the artificial oxygen carriers? The oxygen carriers in the body already, these are the hemoglobins, but that is natural. These are the natural oxygen carrier, that is hemoglobin carry oxygen in the blood. These are RBCs. But artificial oxygen carriers are known as PFC, perfluorocarbon. That we will discuss, I will tell you about in the next slide, that let's see here. I will show you what is the PFC. PFCs are known as artificial oxygen carrier. PFC, perfluorocarbon. This is known as perfluorocarbon. This perfluorocarbon is known as artificial oxygen carrier. So in this process of blood doping, the athletes are injecting artificial oxygen carriers in his or her body. Hemoglobin oxygen carriers are chemicals or purified proteins. These perfluorocarbons are purified proteins which have the ability to carry oxygen to enhance aerobic capacity. Artificial oxygen carriers are hemoglobin oxygen carrier and are chemicals or purified proteins which have the ability to carry oxygen. It enhances aerobic capacity. Blood doping increases the number of RBCs. Overall, the blood doping is increasing the number of RBCs. Hence, the oxygen carrying capacity to the muscle is increased, thereby enhancing the athlete's performance. This is the procedure for how the athlete's performance is increased due to the blood doping. Because blood doping, in which RBCs are increased, when RBCs will be increased in the body, so then what will happen? The oxygen will be carried sufficient amount to the muscles, therefore the athlete's performance will be enhanced. So three type of blood doping we have discussed: autologous, homologous and artificial oxygen carrier. Use of artificial oxygen carrier. These artificial oxygen carriers are in the form of PFCs. Most common PFCs are used. PFCs are the chemicals and this is known as perfluorocarbon. This perfluorocarbon is used by the athletes for third type of blood doping. Next we will come to the gene doping. Gene doping it is the manipulation of cells or genes to enhance the body's sports performance. Or we can say modifying genes enable faster reaction and increase physical strength. So this is a kind of modification in the gene due to the manipulation of the gene, cells of the gene. It is based on the principles of gene therapy. How the gene doping is possible? This is possible with the principle of gene therapy, that is known as gene therapy, when we are bringing change in the genes or DNA. The gene therapy may play a vital role in the growth and development of musculoskeletal structure. It will speed up the repair of the injuries of the muscles, tendons and ligament, etc. The gene doping is done to bring the desired change in the body, to get the desired result from the physiological systems of the body, and it also used for desired growth and development of especially musculoskeletal system structure and other physiological systems, especially respiratory system, circulatory system. This is about the gene doping. Now we will discuss about the substance and the methods which are banned or prohibited from the use in sports. What is responsible for maintaining and updating these substances and methods annually? The methods and substances which are prohibited in sports, are banned in sports. These are revised and these are updated annually. If the substance or method is being used by the athlete for therapeutic use, he will take the permission from concerned authorities. In this case, the physician has to verify it, because sometimes some of these drugs or the medicine that we have discussed, these are sometimes used to save the life of individual. So if these substances or the methods like blood infusion, sometimes infusion of blood, injecting of blood is necessary. We have to take healthy blood of someone when there is, it is needed for any medical use or any therapeutic use. So if the substance or method is being used for therapeutic purpose or medical purpose, so by the verification of the physician or doctor and along with the permission from the concerned authority, the athletes can use it. But otherwise, these are prohibited and these are not allowed to use for the sports person. The list of the substances and methods we have discussed in detail, again I am reminding here: anabolic steroids enhance the performance, serious side effects are there, and the examples are dronabinol and metoprolol. Peptide hormones, these are also prohibited, increase muscle growth and strength and enhance the growth and development, increase RBC counts. The examples are EPO, erythropoietin, human growth hormones, HGH, somatotropin. Beta 2 agonist, it enhances the respiratory efficiency, as we have discussed in detail about it, which is used for the treatment of asthma. But this is used by the sports person to enhance their respiratory efficiency. The examples are acebutolol and बीटाजोलॉल. डायरेटिक्स, दिस इज अनदर सब्सटेंस विच इज यूज बाय द स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन टू रिड्यूस द वेट एंड मैनेज देयर वेट. सो इट द रीजन इज इवेट एंटी डोपिंग टेस्ट एंड अनफेयरली मैनेज द बॉडी वेट. द एग्जाम्पल्स आर डेक्सट्रॉन एंड प्रोवेंसिट. हॉर्मोन्स एंड मेटाबॉलिक मॉड्यूलेटर्स, दे इंटरफेयर विद द फंक्शन ऑफ द एस्ट्रोजन इन द बॉडी. एंड द एग्जाम्पल्स आर टैमोक्सिफेन एंड क्लोमिफेरिन. सो दीज आर द सब्सटेंसेस प्रोहिबिटेड एट ऑल टाइम इन एंड आउट ऑफ द कॉम्पिटिशन फॉर द स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन. एंड द मेथड्स विच आर prohibited at all time in and out of the competitions, these methods are prohibited. Blood doping, that we have discussed the type of blood doping. Autologous, homologous, artificial oxygen carriers, the examples are there. Autologous, homologous, artificial oxygen carriers. The reason of using the blood doping, it increased the RBC counts, RBC numbers in the body, hence it enhanced the oxygen carrying capacity in order to enhance the performance of the sports person. So blood doping, we understand, in which the healthy blood is taken by an athlete. Gene doping, in which the changes, desired changes are done in the gene or DNA. So very significant in growth and development of musculoskeletal structure. This is a desired growth and development in the physiological systems, especially musculoskeletal structure. So this is the example of gene doping. Chemical and physical manipulation, the method is there in which chemical, due to some chemicals, we are bringing change in the physiology. An attempt to tamper the validity of collected samples, this is the reason. So this is the manipulation. So this is about the prohibited substance, prohibited methods all time in and out of the competition. Some of the substances which are only banned during the competition, like substances prohibited in competition, means during the competition, banned only in competitions. During the competition, these are banned. Otherwise, these are not banned. So, stimulants are there. It improves the performance by the stimulating mind and body artificially. That we have discussed stimulant in detail. So, examples are amphetamines, ephedra. This is also known as ephedrine. Caffeine is non-prohibited but monitored. Narcotics are there, reduce the pain. These are, I have discussed them in previous video. These are the higher painkillers. Reduce the pain and allow athlete for persistent efforts. Because when athlete is not feeling any pain, they directly affect our central nervous system. That's why the athlete, the feeling of pain is delayed. So the narcotics are banned. The examples are fentanyl, morphine, oxycodone. These are only narcotics are banned in and out of the competitions, but certain narcotics like fentanyl, morphine and oxycodone, so these are only banned in competition. Rest of the narcotics, the list of narcotics are there, they are banned. I have discussed that narcotics are banned in normally for normal persons as well as for the sports person. So they are banned, all the narcotics are banned in and out of the competition, during the competition and off-season of the competition also for a sports person and all the people. But these are few narcotics which are only banned in competition. Cannabinoids, the derivatives of cannabis sativa, gives feeling of relaxation. So these are banned in competition, hashish and marijuana. Glucocorticosteroids, the fourth number, it gives relief from pain and fatigue, increased tolerance. This is, we have discussed that endurance, for endurance it is used by the sports person. So these are the substances prohibited in competition, only during the competition. Some of the substances which are prohibited in particular sports, like that we will discuss about substances prohibited in particular sports, like alcohol, ethanol, ethyl alcohol it is known as, the chemical name. It is banned in sports, archery, karate, beta blockers, these are known as for banned in archery, shooting, golf. So these substances keep heart rate low and reduce tremble in hand. So that's why these substances are especially banned and prohibited in these sports. Other sports also these are banned, but especially particular in these sports these are banned. So it does not mean that these are not banned in other sports, but these are banned in other sports also, but particularly these sports, these are the particular substances which are commonly used by the these sports persons. So that's why these substances are particularly prohibited in these sports. So this is all about the prohibited substances and the methods which are prohibited in sports and methods of doping. Doping done by the person by using the substances and doping done by the athletes by using the physical methods, and these are banned in sport, these are prohibited in sports, and that we have discussed the WADA, World Anti-Doping Agency, and NADA, National Anti-Doping Agency. These are the agencies which are responsible to detect the use of these drugs in sports in and out of the competition. So they can check the sport person anywhere, anytime, without any prior notice. So these are the substances are, and the methods are banned and prohibited in sport. Because these are the drugs, in case of substances and the methods, we can see then sometimes these are beneficial, these are life-saving for the people. But when these drugs and substances are used for illegal purpose, so then that's why these are banned. These are prohibited in sports at all. So this is all about today's video. So we will come with the next topic in the next video.